Woo-hoo-hoo-hoo! Big day today, fellas, and for more reasons than one, because, well, this is the first major video on this channel where I'm actually using my voice, which I'll probably do more, so, and mainly because a new trailer for the new Tintin game is dropped, Tintin Reporter, Cigars of the Pharaoh. Oh man, okay, I've been waiting for this because, back almost a month ago, Microids, the publisher, posted on their Twitter, it's like, oh, here's a new screenshot, news is right around the corner. And I was like, yes, yes, that means any day now, right? No, it's like almost a month later, I was literally like waiting every day for this. Yeah, as sad as that kind of sounds, but you know, I'm just really excited, you know. But they finally dropped the trailer. Yeah! Alright, so what this video is going to be is just like my first impressions of the trailer. So, not going to be like any deep analysis, but I will be going by like a scene-by-scene kind of thing and just expressing my thoughts and such. So, well, let's get started, really. So yeah, you got the opening logo, which is stylized for Scars of the Pharaoh. Very nice. Microids, but then you get to see Tintin in a Port Said, or however you pronounce it. I'm gonna butcher that, whatever. Port Said, however you. But yeah, he's actually an inn. You don't see that in the book. He just hitches a ride on the fishing boat, and then he's like, "Wow, we're in Port Said." It's like, "Oh, hi, Dr. Sarcophagus. Let's go to the desert." That's the extent of it. But not only is he in an inn. He's doing some reporting. He's on a typewriter writing his report. That is something you don't see very much, period. Not just in non-Cigars of the Pharaoh. You just don't see that in the Tintin series at all, really. The only two notable times I can think of right off the top of my head are like Land of the Soviets and Land of Black Gold. So, yeah, no, it's cool to see him do some actual reporting in this. But then you get to see the MS Isis. Very nice looking. You get to see a cutscene excerpt of Dr. Sarcophagus slipping on some water. That's interesting, yeah. After you see Tintin typing some more on his typewriter. Yeah, you get to see a little camera with him too. It's very nice. Like I said, this game just looks very nice. Then you get to see Tintin in the tomb, having to sidestep his way through pits, and then you see him in the town in his alibi like military outfit, jumping on some crates and such, and then you get to see different forms of gameplay. So in this game, there are different vehicle sections. There are flying sections with the plane that he steals from the town, as well as driving sections, which I assume come at pretty much the end of the game when he's chasing Rastapopoulos the Fakir and the Maharaja Guy Pajama's kidnapped son in the race car. Similar to the last two Tintin games, the movie game and Destination Adventure. So, yeah, the movie game had driving levels and flying sections as well. And Destination Adventure, it had flying levels with the Flight 714, driving levels with the moon tank, even underwater levels with the submarine, Ren Rackham's treasure. Anyway, though, yeah, you get to see some flying levels. I'm assuming he is flying away from Colonel Fodd's bombardiers, just like in the book. But yeah, then you see him in his cabin on the MS Isis with the Thompsons. Looking very dapper. There's a little newspaper on the bench. I don't know what exactly that's supposed to be, but it still looks very nice. And then this scene's interesting. He hops down from a railing onto some sacks on the deck below. I'm assuming this is from a little section where he's chasing the papyrus, in quotations, because if you know the book, it's just a travel brochure. But yeah, I'm assuming he chases after it, just jumping down railings. I don't know why else he would need to do that, so. And then you get a nice shot of Snowy. Snowy looks nice. But yeah, no, this game looks really good. My only gripe is that they don't give a release date. Well, not a solid release date. They only say 2023, and that's a shame, because that probably means that the game's coming out later this year rather than sooner, and I'm a bit bummed about that, but no, otherwise this game looks really good so far. And yeah, I can't wait to see some more of it. Hopefully sooner than later. But Yeah, and the one cool thing, especially with this trailer that I noticed, is that in this one scene, you can hear what appears to be the main theme from the 90s cartoon. I'll play a clip, and you tell me if that sounds like the theme from the 90s cartoon, because it sure as heck does sound like it to me.
Well, an Egyptologist, who invited us to join him in the exploration of Pharaoh Kiosk's tomb in the middle of the desert. Though my journey may be extended by a few days.
Like, I am 95% sure that's the main theme from the 90s cartoon. If so, that's crazy, because Tintin in film and games has always had a different theme. There's never been a main Tintin theme. Everything's been different. But if this game has the 90s cartoon theme, that is literally the first time anything else has used it. And it makes sense why they would choose it. It's the most iconic Tintin theme for sure. But if so, that's really cool. That's really cool indeed. And also with the character designs, they're going for more of a design akin to the movie. With more realistic designs. Like, come on, just look at Tintin. That's definitely based on Tintin from the movie, so. But yeah, no, it's a little weird. I'll get used to it, but I would like something a little bit more akin to the books, but I can live with it. Tintin's voice, I don't know who's voicing him, but it sounds good as well. Also, it seems to be based on Jamie Bell's performance as Tintin from the movie, so yeah, sounds nice. And yeah, no, this game just looks really nice. I like it. I like it a lot. For the first Tintin game in over a decade, like, this seems like it's gonna be worth the wait. And I'm very excited for it, so. Yeah, no, I just can't wait to see some more of this. Very excited. Very excited. And I'll post more videos should more things come about. So, yeah, no, stay tuned for that, and thanks for watching.